Lesson 55, Seeking Spiritual Light. In today's lesson, we shall learn about the blessing and rewards of seeking spiritual light, and the folly and condemnation of those who refuse to receive spiritual light. We shall learn that God delights to respond to our earnest prayers. Also, we shall see how seeking signs will bring God's displeasure and condemnation, because God has already given spiritual light to those who are willing to see. When the disciples ask Jesus to teach them to pray, Jesus teaches them a model prayer, which is commonly known to us as the Lord's Prayer. These men were seeking spiritual light, and the Lord was glad to respond to their request. We could learn much from a careful study of this prayer, but for the sake of time, let's just simply observe that our prayer should always put God first and His kingdom before our own needs. We also should be thankful and praise our God because He is our provider of daily bread. He is merciful to forgive us our debts, and He is our great protector from temptation and from evil. We need His grace and help every day, and so we ought to pray each day and praise Him each day. Jesus also taught that God will reward those who are persistent in prayer, and that when we ask, seek, and knock, God is pleased to give, reveal, and open a way. God loves to hear us pray, and as a good father, He knows how to bless His children with good things. When some accuse Jesus of casting demons out by the power of Beelzebub, Jesus rebukes their folly. Jesus points out that it would not make sense for Satan to cast himself out, for why would he fight against himself? Jesus points out that only someone stronger than Satan could cast out Satan, and this gave evidence to who Jesus really was. Jesus had cast out a demon from a mute man and was also doing many good works. This should have been enough spiritual light to convince everyone that he was God's Messiah. Yet with this spiritual light available, they could not see clearly because they had diseased eyes. Jesus said that the eyes were the light of the body. That is, the eyes allowed the light to enter into the man so he could understand the truth. The fact that Jesus was doing mighty miracles and overthrowing Satan and his demons should have made it obvious that Jesus had God's power working in him. If their eyes were clear and healthy, then the spiritual light would enter in. But because they could not see clearly, the spiritual light was not able to enter in. Their eyes were sick. They were blind to the obvious. When they ask Jesus to perform a sign, they are admitting their state of blindness, for Jesus had been doing many miracles, but they refused to acknowledge or see the signs He had already given. Jesus has to tell them that it is an evil generation that seeks for a sign. He also pointed out that only the sign of Jonah would be given to them. While they could not see clearly any other sign through his miracles, the resurrection, which is the same as the sign of Jonah, would be more than enough proof to his true identity as their Messiah. If they would not believe in him after he was raised from the dead, then nothing he would do would ever be able to convince them to surrender to his authority. Jesus condemns the generation that was seeking for a sign, saying that all the guilt of the former generations would come upon them, for they of all people had the greatest evidence of God's power working among them, and yet they stubbornly refused to see and accept Jesus as God's chosen one. Jesus said that the Queen of the South and Nineveh would be used to condemn them, for they had been given evidence and believed. When the Queen of Sheba visited Solomon and saw the glory of his kingdom and all his wisdom, she was very impressed and knew that God had blessed Solomon above all other kingdoms. When Jonah preached in Nineveh, the people believed his words and repented. These all responded to what was revealed to them. They responded to the spiritual light God had provided to them, even though it was such a smaller light than the light provided by Jesus to those who witnessed his many miracles. That is why the Queen of Sheba and the Ninevites will be just in condemning that generation, which was so much more privileged to have a greater light but refused to accept the light. When a Pharisee invites Jesus to dine in his house, he marvels that Jesus did not wash his hands to eat. Jesus knew his heart and shows him the fault of his thinking. For cleansing the outside is meaningless when the inside is not clean. What Jesus was trying to get across was that while Pharisees were trying to look good on the outside, they were unclean on the inside, for they were full of greed, pride, and evil thoughts. Jesus then pronounces woes against the Pharisees and lawyers for all their religious hypocrisy. Jesus does not withhold the ugly truth of the corruption and evil within these men, but exposes their sin, speaking plainly about their hypocrisy. Jesus speaks about their hidden corruptions, their attention to details of a law, while missing the main point of God's law to love and do justice. He said they honor the dead prophets, but they were no different from their fathers who murdered the prophets because they were seeking to destroy the greatest prophet of all. They wanted to extinguish the spiritual light by getting rid of Jesus. Jesus' words made these men very angry, and they were trying desperately to find some way to accuse him. If only they could have accepted the spiritual light that God had sent to them, then God could forgive and cleanse them. I do hope that you have accepted the spiritual light that God has provided to you through his word by accepting Jesus as Lord of your life. Therefore, take heed that the light which is in you is not darkness. Luke chapter 11, verse 35.